Hi everyone, welcome back to Geeks for Geeks. In this video, we will discuss the problem juggler sequence. So let us read the problem statement and understand what we have to do in this problem and how we'll implement it in terms of code. So the problem says that juggler sequence is a series of integers in which the first term starts with the number, let's say A, and the remaining terms are generated on the basis of the relation. Okay, so basically in juggler term, what happens is if you have to generate the juggler series, so basically you can see here that suppose that you have a particular element. Okay, so if you have a particular element that is already there in the series, so you can say that the next element that you are going to write, it is going to be what? It is going to be basically, if it is even, so it is going to be under root of A. Otherwise, if it is odd, then it is going to be A to the power 3 by 2. Okay, so let me write this series so that you can understand it better. So let us say that if you have been given n value as what? Let's say you have been given n value as 9. Now, how will you write the juggler series? So as of now, if you will see, so you will start writing one answer array, and initially you will push what? Initially you are going to push 9 here. Now, when does this juggler series stop? It stops when the sequence start becoming 1. So whenever the number becomes 1, that is when you will stop here. Okay. So you can see that initially you have got the number as 9, so you will push it inside your answer, and then after this the next term will be what? If the element is odd, then the next term will be what? The next term will be the element to the power 3 by 2. Okay, so since this element is odd, so the next element will be what? Since the current element is 9, okay, here the element is 9, so the next element will be 9 to the power 3 by 2. So what is it going to be? 9 to the power 3 by 2. So 3 can be written as what? 3 square into 3 by 2. So this can be written as 3 to the power 3, that is 27. So the next term will basically be 27. You can see this in this particular case also. You can see here that the next term comes out to be 27. Now next time what is going to happen is that when you will choose the new value of n, so next time the new value of n will be what? This particular value that I have already chosen. So from the back of the array, whatever is the latest answer, and depending whether it is even or odd, that I will do. So basically if I have got 227 here, right? So since it is odd, so I will do what? I will do 3 by 2. Okay, 2 to the power 3 by 2. So 27 can be said as what? Let's say 3 to the power 3. Okay, into 3 by 2 if I have to do. So basically in this particular scenario, what will happen is, if you will do it like this, then you will get the answer as 140. Okay. So when you will solve this expression, so you will get 140 here. So next time what is going to happen here is, next time when you will have 140, so you will do what? You will do 140 to the power what? 140 to the power 1 by 2. Why you will do 140 to the power 1 by 2? Because this number is even. So when the answer dot back, or when the last element that you have updated, it is even. So the next element will be what? Next element, if the last element was even, so next element will be that element under root. So basically 1 by 2 to the power 1 by 2. So then this element is going to be what? I guess it is going to be 11, right? So when you will do it, so this will be basically 11. Now, so when you will get 11 after that, after 140, when you will get 11, so you can see that the previous answer is what? 11. So answer dot back is representing the previous answer, that is 11. Now, since 11 is there, so you will do what? 11 to the power 3 by 2. So when you will do 11 to the power 3 by 2, then you will get the integer version as what? Then you will get the element as 36. Okay. So then you are going to write 36 here. Then after this, next time what will happen? The element is 36. So you will do what? To the power 1 by 2. Okay. So basically you will do the under root if the previous element is even. So then you will get what? Instead of 36, now you will have 6 here. Okay. And that is what is there in your answer as well. Now the answer is 6. So you will do what? 6 to the power 1 by 2. Then you will get what? Then you will get 2 here. Because under root of 6 will be what? It will be 2 point something. So I can write it as 2. Then after this, the next element is 2. Then 2 to the power 1 by 2 when you'll do, so you'll get 1, because 2 is even, so you'll do power 1 by 2. So you'll get 1 here. And this is how you can see that we are getting the sequence. So we are getting 9, 27, 140. Then after that, we are getting 11, 36, 6, 2 and 1. So this is what we are getting here. Now, basically, you can observe that whenever the number, like you have to observe one thing, that whenever the number is odd, okay, so whenever the previous number is odd, then we are doing what? Then we are doing basically A to the power 3 by 2. Okay. And whenever it is even, then what are we doing? Whenever it is even, then we are doing A to the power 1 by 2. So basically you can say, you can write this as what? You can write this as A to the power 1 by 2 plus 1. Okay. And you can write this as what? A to the power 1 by 2 plus 0. So basically you can see here that it depends. If the number is what? If the number is basically odd, then we are doing what? Then we are adding 1 to the power. If it is not odd, then we are not then we are adding 0. So basically the idea is that every time we have to do what? We have to do a to the power 0.5 plus the number modulo 2. Okay. Because if the number is odd, then 1 will get added. If the number is odd, then the modulo result will be how much? Then the modulo result will be nothing but 1. Okay. So basically you can say that we have to do what? A to the power 0.5 plus n modulo 2. So basically every time we have to add 0.5, we have to use 0.5 power directly. That is 1 by 2 power is directly being used, plus either you are doing 0 or you are doing plus 1. Okay. So that depends whether the number is even or odd. So if the number is odd, then you are doing plus 1. If the number is even, then you are doing plus 0. So you can say that we can directly get it without using if else statement even. So what we can do is we can directly write n modulo 2. So if n modulo 2 we are writing, so if the number is even, so 1 will get added. If the number is odd, then n modulo 2 will give me 1. Okay, if the number is even, then n modulo 2 will give me 0. So based on that, whatever I wanted to add will get added. Okay, and this is how I can generate my answer. So what I need to do here is, let's say initially when we are going to start off, so we can say that we can declare a vector, let's say int answer. Okay, now after we declare this answer, so initially in our answer we have to push what? We can push back the number as n. Okay, because initially the very first term is going to be n itself, and then after that what I will do is I'll say that while the number is not equal to 1, okay, till that point of time we have to iterate, because the moment the number becomes 1, that is when we stop our generation of the sequence. Okay, now after this what we will do is we'll say that n will be equal to what? N will be equal to power of n comma 0.5 plus what? Plus basically plus the previous number, plus the previous number, that is answer dot back, we can say answer dot back mod with 2. Answer dot back will tell me what? The previous number of the sequence. Okay, because currently the number is n, so previous number will be what? Like whatever number I have to do 0.5 plus 1 or plus 0, depending whether it was even or odd. Okay, so this is what I will be doing, and then after this we will push back this answer. So we'll say that the new number, whatever we have generated, we'll push it in our n, and that is how we'll keep on proceeding. And so we can say answer dot push back this thing, and then at the end of the day we can return this answer. So we can simply return this answer. Okay, so basically what you are what you are going to do is, basically initially you are going to start, and every time n will be what? Basically every time n will be nothing but whatever is the back element, you have to do modulo with 2, because the power that you will take currently will be what? It will be 0.5 plus a dot back modulo 2. Okay, so that is how you can get this thing done. So I hope that you are clear with this part, guys. Now let's do one thing. Let's try and run this on the samples. It's very easy here. So it is giving me a compilation error. Yeah, I should write answer dot back, because whatever is the last answer, depending whether it is even or odd, I have to check. So that is what we are doing here. So it is running. It is running fine on the samples. Now let's try and submit this code to check if our code is getting accepted or not. It should get accepted. And you can clearly see that our code was able to pass all the test cases. So you can see here what we have done is that initially inside our answer we have pushed n. Then after that, while the number is not equal to 1, till that point of time we have to iterate. And then every time the number will be what? It will be the number to the power 0.5 plus 1 or 0.5 plus 0, depending whether the previous number was even or odd. Okay, and based on that our code will get accepted, because we'll keep on generating the numbers, and whenever the number will become 1, that is when we'll stop and we'll return our answer. So I hope you have understood this clearly. If you have, please make sure to mention that in the comments, and thank you for watching this video. Keep coding, guys.